Shahrukh, I'm going to ask you this question first. You know, we've known that any time of the day or night when a question is asked to the Chief Minister's office, 2 in the morning, he is there in the office. 6 in the morning, he's there holding meetings. And that's the kind of life somewhere that you also led. What makes people like you tick or tick-tock, I would say?
First of all, from the bottom of my heart, apologies for being late. One of the infrastructure issues that we'll talk about, the traffic. I would like to also thank the Honorable CM Saab, because he really is my 3 and 4 a.m. friend. Whenever I'm lonely, I don't call 100, I call Fadnavis Saab. I think, you know, we all have devised methodologies and organizations where we decide that, you know, you have to wake up at a certain time, and then you have to go to work at a certain time, have lunch at a certain time, and then sleep at a certain time. But I think when you start loving your work so much as the CM Saab does, and I've gotten to know this, honestly, once or twice when, and of course, I only remember CM Saab when I'm in trouble. I never call him in good times. Ki, sir, ye problem ho gayi. To main kai baar sochta hoon, aur bahut saare aise log hain jinko main message nahi bhejta hoon. Kyunki ye assumption karna ki mere jaise sab log jaag rahe honge, ye galat hai. But I have sent him messages at 3 a.m. in the morning for an issue which is sometimes personal, sometimes a little more social. And I've got a prompt response in 1 second. So I think if you love your work, it doesn't seem like work. It looks like, you know, just going through daily phase. You eat when you get food, you sleep when you get time, you travel when you have to, and you keep working, because I think he just enjoys his work so much. And for me, it is mera to papi pet ka sawal hai, to mujhe to karna hi padta hai, main chhod nahi sakta.
Ek aur sawal aapse puchta hu. Aaj jab speeches chal rahe the, to shayad kisi ne kaha ki mukhyamantri Nagpur ke hain, lekin Mumbai shahar ko itna unse unko itna lagav kyun hai? You are called, quote unquote, a Delhi boy. But what makes you love Mumbai so much, other than papi pet ka sawal, as you say?
No, I really believe, mujhe sachmuch aisa lagta hai ki main apne aap ki tareef nahi kar raha, but main jeeta jaagta misal hoon main ki is city ke andar hum kahin se bhi ho, jo bhi hamara cultural background ho, jo bhi hamara religion ho, jahan se bhi hum koshish karke ek khwab dekhne ke liye aaye, this is the city of dreams, and main uska jeeta jaagta example hoon. Main sachmuch bolta hoon, isliye nahi ki main modest ho raha hoon, but mera jitna talent ya mere jaisa padha likha bahut sare aise naujawan hain, but mujhe ek opportunity mili Mumbai mein aane ki, aur mujhe community mili, aur wo community phir ek family ho gayi. So I think there is this strange emotion. You know, some cities have emotions. I've been to cities around the world. When you go there, they're very nice, they're very clean, and they're very wonderful, but you don't feel as if you're attached to the city. Perhaps you just go in for a drive or a shopping spree, or just because you have to work. But Mumbai has this feel that it makes you feel apnapan. So whenever somebody comes here, I think jis apnahat se log apne aap ko yahan par, jaise maine paya ki sab logon ne mujhe apna liya, you feel like giving it back. You feel like wanting to tell people that this is the best city in the world. So I think that's what happens for CM Saab also, ki chahe Nagpur ke hon, Kanpur ke hon, Delhi ke hon, Bengal ke hon, UP ke hon, Bihar ke hon, Tamil Nadu ke hon, Gujarat ke hon. I think everybody just comes here with a dream, and the city fulfills the dream, and you feel like giving it back to it. So I think he must be feeling the same, and that's why so many people love him here and in Nagpur, I'm sure.
Shahrukh, I know there are questions that you may want to ask the Chief Minister also, and I'm going to leave you with one thought, that if you were asked, what would you like to do for the city? Somewhere on this forum at Mumbai 2.0, we are asking that it's not only everybody says government should do this, the civic administration should do that, but what are we as citizens doing for the city? So I'm leaving this thought with you right now, and whenever you would like to answer that, but over to you and the Chief Minister, what would you like?
Yeah, I have a couple of questions to start with, and then as we discuss, maybe I'll find some points from it. My first question is, you know, I see CM Saab whenever I've attended functions like this with him or met him personally. Sir, aap jabhi bhi, you know, change ki baat karte hain Mumbai mein. So I see maximum passion in you. I feel there is this drive ki main Mumbai mein change le aunga. So one, how does it come? And why do you feel so strongly to bring these changes? Because it's a city, it's working well, and there are issues, like the lady pointed out, and so many others, I'm sure, but they will get resolved as time goes by. One, your passion for changes in Mumbai, and specifically some of them, plus द टू इश्यूज यू फील गिव यू नाइटमेयर्स अबाउट मुंबई? आपको दो ऐसे कौन से कि यार ये बड़ा ही मुश्किल वाला इशू है?
नहीं, पहले तो मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि फॉर ऑलमोस्ट 20 इयर्स आई वाज अ नॉन रेसिडेंट मुंबई कर, सो बीइंग अ मेंबर ऑफ लेजिस्लेचर असेंबली, वैसे रहता था नागपुर में, लेकिन आधी जिंदगी मुंबई में ही जाती थी, और इसलिए मैं जब देखता था कि मुंबई हैज सो मच ऑफ पोटेंशियल एंड दैट पोटेंशियल इज नॉट बीइंग यूज्ड, सो आई यूज्ड टू रेज दिस थिंग्स इन द असेंबली बट हैड नो चांस टू डू इट. So like, you know, our MMRDA is here, and I used to say that time that MMRDA is not a bank. You are collecting money from people, you are depositing, and you are not reinvesting it. You need to reinvest it. So when I got a chance as a chief minister, I first thing I did was to empty the coffers of MMRDA, to empty the coffers of CIDCO. I said, invest for Mumbai. And I think this passion which comes after looking, you know, various cities doing good, they are developing. When you go world over, you find that Mumbai has everything. Mumbai can be one of the best global cities, but somewhere in infrastructure, in certain other areas, we have not acted. So I always want to act upon it. And when, fortunately, by God's grace, I got the chance, I said, now it's my time to do it. I have been pointing fingers. I have been saying in assembly that this is not done, that is not done, that is not done. Now I cannot say it. Now I have to do it. And so I started doing it. And about nightmares, I think as a chief minister, every day you have a nightmare. So it's very difficult to compare which is worst of your nightmares. But I think I would not say nightmare, but one of the biggest thing which we really need to do in Mumbai, we'll create the infrastructure, we'll transform this city, but at the same time, you know, the huge population of this city which lives in slum, we need to provide them access to, you know, good housing, good life. And when you look at that, fortunately, you know, we have had this SRA scheme for many years, but through SRA we created vertical slums, and there have been reports that now people are catching up different type of illness through, you know, these vertical slums. So fortunately, in the new DCR, we changed the rules, and we said, let the profit come down. But if we are providing them housing, then at least we should provide them decent housing. So we increased the footprint. We increased the open spaces, the areas in those housing. And I think the biggest challenge is that it is very easy to say that we'll build house and we'll provide the house to somebody from slum. It's the most difficult thing to do. And when you have 45% of your population living in slum, the biggest challenge before this city is to provide decent housing to this 45% of people. And I think if we could do it, and it's doable, maybe in next 6, 7, 8, 10 years, we can do it. If we could do it, that will only make this city a global city. Not just doing infrastructure will make it global city, but giving access to decent housing to all these people who live in slum will make this a global city.
So my next question to you is that we will obviously keep on pointing fingers at you now because you're on the other side, jaisa aap karte the assembly ke andar pehle, ki aap ye kyun nahi karte, wo kyun nahi karte. Is there a thing that you genuinely believe that the citizens of Mumbai, all of us, we need to be aware of and do certain things which will help with all the schemes, all the policies, all that needs to be done for Mumbai and the country? I'm sure there are a lot of ideas. Ideas need execution needs time, and time is what we all don't have at and patience from us. So even if we include the fact that we are patient, we'll keep pointing fingers and saying aisa kyun nahi ho raha, aisa kyun nahi ho raha. What can we do? And see, someone from Bollywood or from the Indian film industry, main sirf prachar kar sakta hu ki main bol dun ye achhi baat hai, swachh bharat hai, ya cleanliness theek hai, ya traffic ka jo hai ullanghan na kare. But beyond that, what do you think the normal citizens, I can still use the fact that we are public figures and talk about some goodness for the city, But just normal citizens, what Mumbaikars, what do you expect of them?
No, one thing I would like to say that the biggest asset of this city is its people and the spirit of Mumbai. I think Mumbai has a wonderful culture. I mean, if you go to Delhi or even if you go to Pune, Pune which is cultural capital of Maharashtra, but I would say that the type of discipline which you see in the people of Mumbai, you don't see in any other city. Right now, you know, although people are actually experiencing a lot of trouble in traveling on the roads because of our metro network. In fact, I every day say that on Western Expressway, earlier if people used to travel to their destination for 1 hour, now it's taking 2 hours. But nobody is complaining. Although in their minds they feel that my time is wasted, but they know that after this metro is created, then my life will be, you know, much easier. So they are not, this is Mumbai, these are the Mumbaikars. So whenever Mumbaikars meet me, they compliment me about, you know, building the metros. I always feel that they will say ki kitna yaar tamasha karke rakh diya aap logon ne, do do ghanta hum travel kar rahe aur itni pareshani hum log jhel rahe, aisa koi nahi kehta hai. To mujhe lagta hai ki ye Mumbai ki bahut achhi cheez hai. Aur dusra ye hai ki Mumbaikars ne agar jaisa aapne kaha complain karna chhod diya to hum bhi complacent ho jayenge. So I think it's better कि आप लोग बोलते रहिए, क्या होना चाहिए बोलते रहिए, उससे हम लोगों को भी काम करने में मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि एक ऊर्जा भी मिलेगी और एक दिशा भी मिलेगी. और जितना ज़्यादा लोगों का पार्टिसिपेशन, मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि मुंबई के बारे में एक इमेज कई बार लोग ये कहते हैं कि पीपल मीन बिजनेस, और इसलिए ये लोग जो है बाकी चीज़ों में इंटरेस्ट नहीं लेते, ये अपना काम ठीक ठाक करते हैं. पर मुझे ऐसा लगता नहीं है, मुंबई के लोग जो है ये अपने नेबरहुड में क्या चल रहा है उसकी भी उनको जानकारी होती है और दे आर क्वाइट कंसर्न अबाउट इट. सो ये जो एक मुंबई की एबिलिटी है, यही एबिलिटी मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इसको एक अच्छा शहर बना सकती है. तो मुझे लगता है कि मैं मुंबई के लोगों से क्या एक्सपेक्ट करूँ ये मैं नहीं कह सकता, मुंबई के लोग मुझसे क्या एक्सपेक्ट कर रहे हैं ये जानने की कोशिश मैं करता हूँ, और उसको अगर मैं ठीक से कर पाया तो मुंबई के लोग बार बार मुझे यहाँ बुलाएंगे.
ठीक है सर, क्योंकि आपने बोल दिया कि हम अब आपसे बोल सकते हैं हमें क्या क्या चाहिए, तो मैं बोलना शुरू कर देता हूँ. बिकॉज मेरी फील्ड की बात है एंड ऑब्वियसली मुझे इतना ज्ञान नहीं है सारे एस्पेक्ट्स, वेदर सिविल और इवन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द ट्रैफिक, द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, जो भी चीज़ें हैं मुझे इतना ज्ञान नहीं है. लेकिन मैं अपने बिजनेस की बात कर सकता हूँ, क्योंकि मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इसमें शायद थोड़ी समझदारी होगी कि यू नो व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ बैंगलोर और सम अदर सिटीज इन द साउथ, so there is this the whole international IT structure, not just Indian, is in a certain sense headed by cities there, and they provided the infrastructure. I'm sure all those people around the country are now heading towards there and working in IT sector. There's an extension of IT sector. I understand all the incentives given to visual effects and to Indian film industry, but there is a sector which I feel in the next few years, aane wale saalon ke andar, because of the whole idea of entertainment changing, जो बहुत तेज change हो रहा है, मुझे लगता है हमारे देश में सबसे ज़्यादा होगा, whether it is online, whether it's on telephony, whether it's in cinema. तो मेरा सवाल ये है कि एक visual effects जो हैं वो जो हैं बहुत बड़ी बात बन जाएगी, और वो एक natural extension है IT sector का, और एक natural marriage है, क्योंकि पूरी दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी film industry जो है मुंबई में स्थित है, दुनिया की, ये भी नहीं कि हमारी कंट्री की सिर्फ, सारी दुनिया की सबसे बड़ी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री जिसमें विजुअल इफेक्ट्स हैं. हमारी टेलीविजन इंडस्ट्री बहुत सारा यहाँ से यूजेज लेती है. मोस्ट ऑफ द टैलेंट, इफ आई मे से सो, व्हिच इज़ वर्किंग इन मीडिया, स्टेम्स फ्रॉम और स्टेज इन मुंबई और हैज़ हेडक्वार्टर्स. सो व्हाई हैवंट वी अप्लाइड अ माइंड्स टू टेक दिस नेचुरल प्रोग्रेशन फ्रॉम द आई टी इंडस्ट्री व्हिच हैज़ डेवलप्ड सो मच इन द कंट्री, टू शव इट एंड गिव इंसेंटिव्स फॉर विजुअल इफेक्ट्स एंड स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स एंड even animation. These are three different categories, people mix them together, but animation, visual effects and special effects to become something that the world comes to us. They don't go to Domino's, they don't go to Industrial Light and Magic like Singapore has done it, and hamara natural ek marriage lagta hai yahan pe ho sakta hai. So why wouldn't that is something that is the government looking at, are you looking at? And of course main aapko uska blueprint banakar bhejunga zarur.
ज़रूर आपका ब्लू प्रिंट, विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू हैव दैट ब्लू प्रिंट. बट हैविंग सेड दैट, यू सी, now all this has become part of Industrial Revolution 4.0. The fourth industrial revolution is all about the things which you have said. And in fact, in all our policies, as you rightly said, our policies were quite watertight. And in fact, in our IT sector, we allowed concessions for IT, but not about all these industries which are offshoot of IT industries. Now we have changed the policy. And in our entire IT policy as well as industrial policy, we have made this allowed. So the spaces which earlier you were able to use only for IT, now you will also be able to use for all these industries, whether it's visual effect, whether it is animation, everything. And again, in the definition of our industry, this fourth industrial revolution, which has a different potential of technologically, you know, innovative industries, were lacking. So we have also included that. So now maybe in our MIDCs or our industrial estates or on, in our SEZ, if you want to create such facilities, you have all the, you know, incentives which other industries would also get. So I think we have already started that. But for us also, it's a very new area. So we'll be very happy if you could give that policy to us. We'll be very happy to adopt the policy.
और पूछ सकता हूँ? सर ने कहा कुछ भी पूछ लो.
बिल्कुल कुछ भी पूछ लीजिए. उनकी इजाजत अगर आपको है तो.
May I? I hope I'm not taking too much time. The other area that I always feel, which I really believe in, और मुझे लगता है कि सभी जो माँबाप हैं, जितने बच्चे हैं, there's one thing which is education. और मुझे लगता है बहुत अच्छी है. मैं किसी भी तरह से उसको criticize नहीं कर रहा. I think some of the best schools, colleges, and institutions and faculties we find in Mumbai and all over the country also. We have All India Institute of Medical Sciences, बहुत अच्छे अच्छे doctors हम लोग वहाँ से निकाल रहे हैं. IITs हैं जहाँ से बहुत सारे engineers and software engineers आ रहे हैं. But I have a question कि मुंबई के अंदर I'm sure बहुत कोशिश चल रही है एजुकेशन में, बिकॉज मुझे लगता है एजुकेशन फ्यूचर है सर. सो हो सकता है मेरा सवाल बिल्कुल क्लियर कट ना हो, बट आई ट्रूली बिलीव कि बहुत सारी स्पेशलाइज्ड एजुकेटेड थिंग्स हैं, जिसकी वजह से इंक्लूडिंग माई सेल्फ, हम जो है कभी कभी कोशिश करके शायद हम अफोर्ड कर सकते हैं तो हम कर लेते हैं, लेकिन अपने बच्चों को अब्रॉड भेजते हैं पढ़ने के लिए. मेरा सबसे बड़ा मानना ये था, मैं हिंदुस्तान में बड़ा हुआ हूँ, मुझे लगता है यहाँ की एजुकेशन जो है बहुत स्पेसिफिक, अच्छी और वाइड है. बट आई स्टिल फील दुनिया इतनी जल्दी बदल रही है कि देर आर एरियाज वेयर स्पेसिफिक एजुकेटेड एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशंस कैन ओनली हैपन विद कोलैबोरेशन परहैप्स, कि हम शुरुआत से शुरू करने की कोशिश करें. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ़ इट्स इन सॉफ्टवेयर, इफ़ इट्स इन प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिल्म्स, क्योंकि मेरा बिजनेस है, वी ऑलवेज फील कि हमको शुरुआत से शुरू करनी पड़ेगी, शायद हम लैग बिहाइंड कर जाएं. So is there a purpose or a thought behind collaborating with specialized institutions like other countries I've heard have done, ki wo colleges ko yahan par affiliate kiya jaye hamare education system ke sath, so we can get that specialized education in Mumbai?
Yeah, I think now even the central government has changed its rules. So earlier it was very difficult for a foreign university to come to India and have its campus or to collaborate with one of our universities or one of our institutions, but now it is possible, and the central government has also changed the rules, so many of them are coming. And secondly, in our state, we have actually enacted a law. Under this law, you can have a self-financed university, and we have said that these all private universities should be in specified fields. So the conventional, all the curriculums for that, we have conventional universities. We don't need private or such type of universities, but for very specific, new type of curriculums, new type of jobs where you require entirely new type of human resource, you require universities. So I think by now, at least 15 self-financed universities have been established in Maharashtra, where we have passed legislation in our legislature. And through that legislation, we have allowed them to, establish their universities. And in many of these universities, they are actually coming up with very innovative courses. And again, I think in our conventional universities also, now they have also started collaborations with few of the foreign institutions. Now recently, I think in Mumbai University, we started the first institute in artificial intelligence. And the Vadhvani Foundation, the Vadhvani brothers who now live in America, they have a foundation, they have collaborated with the Mumbai University, and it is first of its kind. So it's the first institute into artificial intelligence in India, which has been set up in Mumbai University. So I think a lot of things are happening, but I totally agree that we need to do more, because our conventional system of developing a curriculum and giving approvals to that, now is a time when by the time you approve a curriculum, it becomes obsolete. So you have to be very quick. So those things we have also started adopting, but now we require more private players, to come into this field, and fortunately now it's allowed. So I think with private players, more innovation can be brought to the education system.
And so I wasn't completely aware of it. So from my side, I would request all the corporates and everyone to formulate collaborations with existing colleges and universities in Mumbai, and create these very specialized faculties, because the world is changing so much that I think we really, really need to have this collaborative system to start off, and then perhaps develop our own curriculum which keeps up with the rest of the world. So finally, I'd just ask you, what is your vision? Main ye sab ye corporate log hain yahan pe, to vision mission hota hai, to aapka vision kya hai Mumbai ke liye?
Nahi, mujhe aisa lagta hai, kai baar log mujhe poochte hai, aur pehle log ye kehte the ki विल मेक मुंबई को हम शंघाई बनाएंगे, विल मेक शंघाई, बट मुझे लगता है कि मुंबई इज़ मुंबई, इसका एक अपना कल्चर है, इसका अपना एक स्पिरिट है, मुंबई की का एक अपना फ्लेवर है. सो मुझे लगता है कि उसी मुंबई के फ्लेवर को हम लोग बरकरार रखते हुए, कीपिंग इट इंटैक्ट, आई वॉन्ट टू मेक मुंबई मोर एक्सेसिबल टू एवरी मुंबईकर. जैसे आपने कहा, ये सिटी ऑफ ड्रीम्स है, हर आदमी यहाँ आता है और उसका ड्रीम पूरा होता है, लेकिन एक बड़ा तबका मुंबई का ऐसा है कि जिसका ड्रीम पूरा नहीं हो पाया है, जो ड्रीम लेकर आया है लेकिन अभी भी स्ट्रगल कर रहा है, उसके लिए भी मुंबई, उसकी ड्रीम्स पूरी करने वाली मुंबई बने, इस प्रकार की का माहौल हमको यहाँ तैयार करना है, और मुझे लगता है यही मेरा मिशन है, दैट्स माई मिशन.
वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन शाहरुख खान, इफ यू कैन spare your 3 a.m. friend for a few minutes, because he's been for the last 20 days attending to all questions in the state assembly as well. One question to you, since I started that with you. Other than cinema, if there is one space would you like to devote to the city of Mumbai, what would that space be?
Mine personally would be education. That's why I asked that question, because mujhe bachpan se mujhe teachers bahut acche lagte hain, aur main actor se zyada teacher khud banna chah raha tha. और अब मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि मुझे मौका मिला है, एटलीस्ट मेरे फील्ड में मैं ऐसा कुछ क्रिएट कर सकता हूँ जिससे नौजवान बच्चे, बिकॉज यू नो विद सोशल मीडिया, मीडिया इटसेल्फ हैज़ बिकम अ लार्जर प्लेटफॉर्म देन इट वाज जस्ट विद टेलीविजन एंड फिल्म्स, वेदर इट वाज इंडियन फिल्म्स और इवन इंटरनेशनल टेलीविजन. आई थिंक सोशल मीडिया इज़ मेकिंग एवरीबडी मीडिया सैवी, और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि हमारे पास अभी भी वीडियो लिटरेसी कम है. हम जो लोग हैं, बनाई से वीडियो लिटरेसी, आई एक्सप्लेन इट फॉर अ मिनट, हम लोग जो हैं बोल बच्चन वाले हैं, हमारा जो कल्चर है बात करने वाला है, हम म्यूज़िक सुनने वाले हैं, हमारे देश में जितने भी लोग हैं हम बातचीत बहुत करते हैं, लेकिन विजुअल मीडियम जो है उसको हम कम ध्यान देते हैं. हम बहुत खूबसूरत पोएट्स भी होते हैं, हमारे सिंगर्स भी हैं, राइटर्स भी हैं, एंड आई एम श्योर आर्टिस्ट भी हैं, बट विजुअल मीडियम इतनी तेज़ बढ़ रहा है दुनिया के अंदर. फॉर एग्ज़ाम्पल, पहले हम जब ट्विंकल ट्विंकल लिटिल स्टार सुनते थे तो इमेजिन करते थे कैसा सब कुछ होगा, या डैफोडिल सुनते थे, अब सब कुछ इंटरनेट पे अवेलेबल है. एंड आई थिंक वो सब चीज़ों को समझने और गलत चीज़ों को उस समझ से अलग हटाने के लिए वीडियो लिटरेसी बहुत ज़रूरी है. सो बिकॉज वो मेरा मीडियम है, मीडिया एंड वीडियो, सो आई फील अगर एजुकेटिव फील्ड के अंदर मैं कोई ऐसी चीज़ कर सकूँ तो मेरे को लगेगा मैं मुंबई को अपनी जो मुझे ज़िंदगी मुंबई ने दी है, जो आई थिंक दुनिया में सबसे बेहतरीन और खूबसूरत है, तो बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मुंबई का, मुंबईकर्स का, आप सब का. बट मेरा दिल ये है कि मैं कुछ छोटा सा अगर कुछ कर सकूं तो एजुकेशन फील्ड में करना चाहूंगा।
बच्चों के लिए अगर डिजिटल लाइब्रेरीज बनानी हो मुंबई शहर में तो उसका आप सहयोग?
मोस्ट सर्टनली। और मेरा एक और है कि मैं आर्काइवल में मानता हूं कि चीज़ें आर्काइव होनी चाहिए, और मुंबई में इतनी सारी चीज़ें हैं, हमारे पास है फिल्म डिवीजन है यहाँ पे, और मुझे मालूम है कुछ लोग अब कोशिश भी कर रहे हैं, बट मेरा बहुत शौक है कि मैं एक आर्काइवल सेंटर करूँ, एंड दैट आर्काइवल सेंटर कैन डेवलप फॉर डिजिटल कंटेंट फॉर चिल्ड्रन आल्सो। तो बच्चों का भी काम होगा, और जो हमारी पुरानी चीज़ें हैं मुझे लगता है हम उन्हें घुमा देते हैं, क्योंकि फिल्म इज़ अ वेरी इम्परमनेंट मीडियम, बट नाउ विद ऑल द काइंड ऑफ डिजिटल स्टफ वी हैव, आई थिंक वी कैन रिटेन इट, लर्न फ्रॉम इट, एंड I personally believe India, Mumbai, all of us have the best stories to tell. Hamare maa baap, grandparents, wo purani jo kahaniyan sunate the. I think we need to keep them alive. I think it's not just about remixing a song. It's about representing it again to the younger generation to tell them what our culture and where we came from. And I think our stories are going to be the best stories in the world rather than stealing stories from here and there and putting it back. And I also want to just make one last point, sorry, is that, you know, when Fadnavis Saab talks about the resilience of Mumbaikars, ki agar waqt thoda zyada lag raha hai to ek patience hai, patience se zyada ek resilience hai, hamari city mein kai baar, whether it's been rains, whether it's been traffic jams, whether it's been other kind of wrongdoings, problems hui hain yahan par, lekin Mumbai has always been resilient and has come forth and stood forth and fought everything off with love and kindness plus a lot of guts. But mujhe aisa lagta hai ki the other thing we should add to Mumbaikar is the magical part of Mumbaikar. Ek hai resilient Mumbai hai, ek hai khubsurat Mumbai hai, but I think ek magical Mumbai banane ki bahut zarurat hai humko. Aur main isliye kahunga uske andar teen C's hain sir, which I believe should be encouraged in a city like ours because hum itne diverse hain. I think healthy competition between companies, between people, between every aspect of life in Mumbai, ki hum compete karein ek dusre se, even government agencies to compete with each other, ki kaun behtar kaam kar sakta hai. So I think healthy competition. The second part is creativity. I think Mumbai is a hub of creativity. Hum kehte rehte hain ki business, Mumbai is the city of business. I think it is a city of creativity. Kyunki aajkal ka jo medium hai, wahan creative log बहुत अच्छा है कि छोटे छोटे फंक्शंस, छोटी छोटी आर्ट गैलरीज में सब कुछ होता है, बट आई थिंक द वर्ल्ड हैज़ बिकम लार्जर एंड इफ इट हैज़ टू गो टू द रेस्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड इट विल हैव टू टेक द डिजिटल रूट. तो यहाँ पे क्रिएटिव हब हम क्रिएट करें कि जो भी क्रिएटिव आदमी है, सिर्फ फिल्मों में नहीं बट गायक हैं, पेंटर्स हैं, पोइट्स हैं, यहाँ पर आकर अपना एक फ्यूचर देख सकें, एक सोशल इन्वायरमेंट ऐसा हो. एंड थर्ड सी इज कल्चरल इंक्लूसिवनेस, वो बहुत ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है क्योंकि हम इतने डाइवर्स हैं, हम एक दूसरे का किसी भी किस्म का झगड़ा, किसी किस्म का कल्चरल या रिलीजियस एस्पेक्ट जो है, वी शुड नेवर एवर क्वेश्चन. आई वुड लाइक एक्चुअली, इफ इट इज़ पॉसिबल, आई नो लेजिस्लेचर इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल, दैट एवरीबडी इन मुंबई शुड सेलिब्रेट एवरी रिलीजियस फेस्टिवल. नॉट दैट वी डोंट डू इट, वी ऑलरेडी डू इट, बट दैट शुड बी एन एस्पेक्ट कि हम सब लोग जो हैं, चाहे वो गणपति विसर्जन है, चाहे वो ईद है, चाहे वो होली है, चाहे वो दशहरा है, चाहे वो दिवाली है, विच एवर एस्पेक्ट है, चाहे गुरु नानक जयंती है, वी शुड ऑल come together as a city, and there should be an attitude that we are inclusive about cultures. We'll be inclusive about cultures, creativity will come. If creativity is there, competition will come. And if all these three C's get fulfilled, I think Mumbai is will become even more magical than it is right now.
Shah Rukh Khan, thank you so much. And Mr. Fadnavis, thank you very much. The Badshah of cinema and the Badshah of Maharashtra's governance, both of them. Thank you once again. Before you leave, you talked about the magic. तो उस जादू को अगर आगे बढ़ाते हैं, फिनटेक इज़ वन स्पेस वेयर महाराष्ट्र डन अ लॉट एंड देर आर 10 सच कंपनीज, यंगस्टर्स, स्टार्टअप्स हुव डन रिमार्केबल वर्क एंड महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट हैज़ अवार्डेड देम फॉर देयर फाइन वर्क. वी गॉट दीज 10 स्टार्टअप यंगस्टर्स हियर. कैन वी क्विकली आस्क देम टू कम अप इन द नेक्स्ट 40 सेकेंड्स? इफ यू आर नॉट हियर देन द फोटो ऑप इज गॉन.
मैं सूट पहने रखूँ कि उतार दूँ?
ये एक आपसे सवाल पूछना था कि आपने ओके सो मोर देन दैट Okay, can you quickly be enlightened? Thank you.
My name symbolized all that was corrupt to society. His name symbolized all that was pure. And I was being held in the embrace of a man who was pure.
Got you.